Welcome to Learning English, a daily 30-minute program from the Voice of America. I'm Ashley Thompson.
And I'm Mario Ritter, Jr. This program is designed for English learners, so we speak a little slower and we use words and phrases especially written for people learning English.
Today, Ana Mateo reports on how South Koreans are using social media to help popularize shamanism. For this week's science report, Brian Lin tells us what to expect during a possible star explosion. We close the show with the lesson of the day. But first,
in South Korea, the prayer table of Lee Kyung Hyun looks similar to those of Korean shamans from hundreds of years ago. It has statues of Buddha and local gods, candles, and incense. The 29-year-old shaman may use traditional prayer objects, but Lee reaches her followers in a modern way, through social media. Hundreds of thousands of people follow her online. And she's not alone. Since starting her YouTube channel in 2019, she has noticed more South Korean shamans posting videos about the spiritual practice. Researcher Kim Dong-kyo is with the Academic Center for K-Religions at Sogong University, a private research university in Seoul. He said shamans used to publicize themselves in newspapers. He said it is natural for them to use social media. South Korea is among the world's most modern and high-tech economies. More than half its population of 51 million does not practice a religion, research shows. However, the appeal of shamanism remains popular and seems to be growing. Google Trends tracks popular searches on YouTube. It shows that searches for shaman and fortune-telling in Korean have nearly doubled over the past 5 years. A 2024 Korean film called Exuma is about a shaman removing a curse on a family. The film has made at least $97 million internationally and is raising interest in the religious tradition. The Korean Film Council says that 1 in 5 South Koreans has seen the film. Shamans are thought to have special powers, including the ability to know what will happen in the future. They offer followers relationship advice, guidance on job searches, and predictions, said Lee. Park Chae-bin is a 33-year-old Buddhist. In 2020, she visited Lee when she was struggling to find a job. She said she felt peace of mind after meeting with the shaman. Park said, "I was very anxious at the time, but I became a little relaxed after deciding to let things go and focus on what I need to do." She found a job at about the same time as her visit with the shaman. Shaman Lee posts videos on subjects such as Korea's future for the rest of 2024. The current state of South Korean society is a factor that can't be ignored, she said. She added that many people come to her with concerns about the costs of housing and raising children. In Seoul, where Lee works, the price of a home was more than 15 times the average wage in 2022. In 2017, a home in the Korean capital, cost 8.8 times the average wage. These amounts come from a Korean government report. The country has also suffered from high inflation and interest rates. Han Sung-hyun is an assistant professor at the Academy of Korean Studies, a research center under the Ministry of Education. Han says that younger shamans who live in the city connect well with their younger followers. These people are facing economic difficulties and are looking for help. In 2022, a culture ministry agency estimated that there were between 300,000 and 400,000 shamans and fortune tellers in South Korea. The agency website calls shamanism an important and powerful part of Korean tradition. Its roots date back at least 2,000 years, said Han. Han also noted that larger religions, such as Christianity and Buddhism, make up about 40% of South Korea's population. He added that they are more influential in society and do not receive similar criticism. However, Lee said that Christians also visit shamans in South Korea. Even churchgoers want to have their bad dreams read, she said. People used to hide that they live as a shaman. There was a lot of stigma, said 51-year-old Unmi Pang. She has been a shaman for almost 20 years. She said that modern shamans are more willing to publicize themselves than those of the past. The activities or practices of shamans may involve ringing bells and throwing rice. They may also sing and dance. Many worship local gods, such as the Mountain God, Great Spirit Grandmother, and Dragon King. More recently, some shamans have found themselves in legal trouble. Local media in Seoul reported that a 66-year-old shaman was sentenced to 4 years imprisonment in February. A court had found him guilty of cheating a follower out of $200,000. Some people in South Korea's influential communities have links to shamans. Min Hee-jin is a top entertainment industry leader with a major K-pop music company. In April, she defended herself in a press conference against accusations that she used a shaman for business purposes. Min said she simply talked with a shaman to feel better. "Don't you guys all do that too?" she asked reporters. A 2022 report in the journal BMC Psychiatry noted a huge space between South Koreans needing mental health treatment and getting it. The report partly blamed this on stigma. People have stigmatized shamanism as something dirty, suspicious, and scary, said Han, the assistant professor at the Academy of Korean Studies. He added that people were sometimes accused of visiting shamans in attempts to hurt their reputation. I'm Ana Mateo.
The American Space Agency, NASA, says a huge star explosion is expected to light up the night sky later this year. NASA describes it as a once-in-a-lifetime event. The event is known as a nova. It happens when changes to a star cause it to release a large amount of energy and it becomes very bright. This activity is only temporary, and such stars usually return to their normal state after experiencing a nova event. Astronomers have predicted the nova is likely to happen by September 2024. The expected event will involve a two-star system called a binary system in the constellation Corona Borealis, also known as the Northern Crown. This constellation is about 3,000 light-years from Earth. A light-year is the distance light travels in a year, about 9.5 trillion kilometers. The binary system is called T Coronae Borealis. It contains two gravitationally linked stars, a white dwarf and a red giant. NASA describes a white dwarf as the remains of an Earth-sized star that died. A white dwarf is formed when the star burns off all its central nuclear fuel and loses its outer layers. A red giant forms when a star releases large amounts of hydrogen at its center. This loss of energy causes the star to begin to collapse. But the process also increases the red giant's temperature and pressure, leading to new releases of energy that can affect nearby objects. Astronomers say a red giant's release of hydrogen in a binary system causes a heavy buildup of pressure and heat on the white dwarf. Over time, such buildup can cause a thermonuclear explosion, large enough to blast away the material the white dwarf had collected. This process differs from a supernova. NASA describes a supernova as an extremely bright, super powerful explosion of a star. The main difference is that a supernova is the final destruction that happens at the end of a particular star's life. In a nova, the white dwarf remains active after the event. Scientists believe novas appear to repeat, on average, about every 80 years. NASA notes that nova events can keep happening for tens of hundreds or thousands of years. That is why the space agency called the upcoming nova a once-in-a-lifetime event. Scientists say the nova explosion will be so bright, people should be able to see the resulting light without telescopes or other special equipment. The bright light can make it appear as though a new star has formed in the sky. It will be at least the third time humans have witnessed a nova, the French news agency AFP reports. The event was first discovered by Irish astronomer John Birmingham in 1866 and then reappeared in 1946. Sumner Starfield is a professor of astrophysics at Arizona State University. He told AFP he was very excited to see the nova event. He has studied the T Coronae Borealis star system at different times since the 1960s. Starfield is currently working on a scientific paper to predict what astronomers will learn about the repeating nova whenever it shows up. It could be today, but I hope it's not, he joked. Rebecca Hounsell is a research scientist specializing in NOVA events at NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center in Maryland. She said that interest in the event may create a lot of astronomers out there. She hopes this can give young people a cosmic event that they can observe for themselves, ask their own questions, and collect their own data. She added that the NOVA event might even be helpful to fuel the next generation of scientists. I'm Brian Lynn.
Brian Lynn is here now to talk more about his science report. Thanks for joining me, Brian.
Of course, Ashley. Thank you for having me.
This week, you looked ahead at a cosmic event NASA expects to happen this year, a huge star explosion known as a nova. We learned that if the nova happens, people on Earth will likely be able to see the resulting light burst. Have astronomers been able to narrow down a more exact date range for this expected event?
At this point, NASA and other astronomers are saying the most likely target for the nova is the month of September, probably mid-September. That date was calculated by examining past nova events as well as current changes going on with the two-star system. But the scientists studying this activity say the nova could really happen at any time between now and September. And this is one reason NASA decided to put publicity about this event out there now to give people some time to prepare and in case it does happen early.
And what have astronomers been saying about what people on Earth will actually see when this nova does happen?
So one way they have described this is to say that a nova can produce an effect after the explosion that looks almost like a new star has formed in the sky. So this is what people will really be looking for, a very bright spot that looks similar to a bright space object. And scientists have also said they think this bright burst will remain visible in the sky for at least several days, perhaps even longer.
All right. Thanks so much for that report, Brian. And thank you for joining me.
You're welcome, Ashley. Thank you.
VOA Learning English has launched a new program for children. It is called Let's Learn English with Anna. The new course aims to teach children American English through asking and answering questions and experiencing fun situations. For more information, visit our website, learningenglish.voanews.com.
My name is Anna Mateo.
My name is Andrew Smith.
And I'm Jill Robbins.
You're listening to The Lesson of the Day on the Learning English Podcast. Welcome to the part of the show where we help you do more with our video series, Let's Learn English. This series shows Anna Mateo in her work and life in Washington, D.C.
In today's lesson, we're going to start with some questions. How long have you been studying English? How long have you been working at your job? And How long have you been living in your town or city?
Each of these questions shares something similar. Did you notice what it was? They all use the auxiliary verb have, the past participle been, and the ing form of the main verb. Have been studying, have been working, have been living.
That structure with the auxiliary have or has, the past participle been, and the ing form makes the present perfect continuous tense. We'll explain more about it during today's lesson. But first, let's listen to some of Lesson 50 of the Let's Learn English series.
In Lesson 50, Anna decides to go back to school and take some classes at a university. Listen to Anna as she talks to other students, and listen for the present perfect continuous tense.
Hey, are you finished with your report?
Almost. I've been writing and rewriting since last night. The subject is really interesting to me.
Me too. I've been studying this topic for a long time.
Am I late?
You're a little late, but don't worry, the professor isn't here yet.
How long has the class been waiting?
We've only been waiting for about 10 minutes.
So, how long have you been studying at Georgetown?
I've been studying here since 2015.
Awesome. You know, I've been wanting to go back to school for a long time. So, here I am.
Well, you picked a great school. I've been really happy here.
Studying, waiting, and wanting are all activities or states that last for a period of time. That is why we call these continuous actions.
In contrast, a very quick action, like dropping a pencil or turning on a light, is not a continuous action. It happens quickly and usually does not continue.
We express continuous actions with the present perfect continuous tense. And did you notice that there are two ways to answer the question, how long? Listen again to these two questions and answers.
How long has the class been waiting?
We've only been waiting for about 10 minutes.
So, how long have you been studying at Georgetown?
I've been studying here since 2015.
If we say the amount or length of time in our answer, we use the preposition for.
We've only been waiting for about 10 minutes.
And if we give an exact date or an exact time that the activity started, we use since.
I've been studying here since 2015.
Now listen to Andrew and me ask and answer a few questions. And try to notice how we use the words for and since when we answer the questions. Andrew, how long have you been working at Voice of America Learning English?
Not very long. I've been working at Voice of America since August of 2022. So, I've been working here for about a year and a half now. How about you, Jill? How long have you been working at VOA?
I've been working here since 2014. So, I've been here for about 10 years now.
The present perfect continuous can be easy to learn if you repeat the form like this. I've been working. I've been living. I've been studying. I've been teaching. I've been learning. And so on.
And be sure to practice with other subjects or pronouns like this. You've been working. She's been working. He's been working. We've been working. They've been working.
This sounds like something we could make into a good chant or a song to help our listeners.
I think so. Maybe if we have more time, we'll make one. But now, let's go to the really fun part of Lesson 50. As usual, Anna makes some silly mistakes. She gives a presentation to the class, but it's on the wrong topic.
Anna misunderstood the topic because she confused two similar-sounding words. Listen for these two words. Also, when you listen, see if the voice of the professor sounds familiar.
Here comes the professor.
Hello, class. Sorry I'm late, but the snowstorm made getting here really difficult. I see you've been waiting very patiently. So let's get started. Who wants to give their talk first?
Oh, please, please pick me.
Anna?
Oh, me? Sure. Thanks. Here is my report on violins in the city. People have been looking for a solution to the problem of violins in the city. I say stop, stop! They are not the problem. In fact, violins are part of the solution. Violins create beautiful music that can fill a city with hope.
Anna.
If we put a violin in the hands of every child.
Anna, the topic is violence in the city. Violence, not violins.
Like I was saying, many people are saying that violence in the city is a big problem, a very big problem.
Violins and violence. Those words do sound similar. Listeners, have you ever been confused by two words in English that sound almost the same? Write to us and let us know. And Dr. Jill, I noticed that the professor's voice sounds, well, it sounds a lot like you.
That's because it is me.
Well, you do a good job acting like a professor. And maybe that's because you have been a professor in real life.
In fact, I was a professor at Georgetown University. We should also tell our listeners that Lesson 50 takes place at Georgetown University here in Washington, D.C. We'd like to again thank Georgetown and its students for helping us with Lesson 50 of Let's Learn English. Listen to Anna explain more about Georgetown at the beginning of Lesson 50.
Hello, and welcome to Georgetown University in Washington, D.C. I am going back to school.
Georgetown is the oldest Catholic and Jesuit university in the United States. The Jesuits are a religious order known worldwide for their many colleges and universities. Students have been studying here since 1792.
And Georgetown is just one of many universities in Washington, D.C. Well, Jill, we've been doing today's lesson for maybe around 10 minutes, so I think it's time to say goodbye.
But remember to email us about words that sound similar to you. Send your email to learningenglish@voanews.com. And you can also find us on YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram. Thanks for listening. I'm Dr. Jill.
And I'm Andrew Smith.
That's our program for today. Join us again tomorrow to keep learning English through stories from around the world. I'm Ashley Thompson.
And I'm Mario Ritter Jr.